some red flags that we saw in terms of porta potties being delivered, but EMS first responders being told to stand down. What are some of the biggest red flags to you?
Well, again, I got to make sure that we're trying to put a puzzle together. And the first piece of the puzzle, once shots are fired, I want to know, and they won't tell me under the Connecticut Freedom Information Act, who did not order those helicopters. It is crucial. It is crucial in every mass casualty. The second thing is I want to know who the person and the incident command made a decision not to let the paramedics and the EMTs inside the schools, knowing that there are children that could be potentially serious, people clinging to life, and the paramedics are told to stay outside and set up their triage areas. And if you saw it on television, you got two of them, and one of them is completely wrong.
So nobody is allowed, no paramedics are allowed in?
No paramedics. Right. Believe that? Can you imagine you're a parent knowing that your child is in there, shots are fired, and you're thinking that your child might be injured, and they do not let the paramedics and the EMTs in the school?
And you've investigated these other school shootings. That's never happened before.
Well, it has never happened. And you know what? Columbine is the first time where law enforcement actually came out on national television. The SWAT team member said, we made a mistake. Can I tell you what? I would have so much respect for all those SWAT team and police officers. They said we should have gone in. We shouldn't have waited 3 hours. But remember, that was a hostage situation. That's completely different. Mm-hmm. But that's where the active shooter drills are coming from. Now, the first one gets there, you go in, you neutralize the threat. It's your job. You don't wait for a bunch of people. You get there because guess what? People are depending on you to neutralize the threat. Here, we neutralize the threat within the first 8 minutes. I mean, it's done. 8 minutes? Supposedly the shooter killed himself. Guess what?
Yeah.
I mean,
And they've got a body count within, what was it, 11 minutes?
Yeah, and who declared them dead? I want to know who declared all of those people legally. And you know what? I can't get it. And I'm using the Connecticut Information Act, which what? It's public record. There's no secret in this stuff. And they won't let the American people know who that was. And in Connecticut, only a doctor can declare them legally dead or a certified special licensed RN.
Wow. Now, even though they won't let the EMS personnel in, they're not calling Life Flight in, there's no lawsuits from the parents in this. And that's
not
also another
one.
First, isn't it?
I read it never in the history. I promise you. If we Google and people do their homework and do their research, that's a piece of the puzzle. Never, ever have you not ever seen a lawsuit not filed. That's unheard of.
Yeah. And
why?
I would think, especially if they're holding back EMS personnel, that would be liability right there. Exactly. Not calling
in
the helicopters, holding the people back that do get there. I mean, that would be huge liability right there.
I would call it negligence. Mm-hmm. It is negligence.
Yeah.
That's my opinion as an expert. But when you don't provide medical aid as quickly as possible, I think you have serious, serious problems. And I hope the people and your listeners agree with this.
Now, there were some other peculiar things about the way the parents behaved. Can you go into that?
Well, can I stay with one more issue?
Sure.
If you ever watch, I mean, it's like almost they wanted you to see certain things. SWAT team, I want to know who trained the SWAT team members for the Connecticut State Police that day. You see them marching in there in group of twos. I mean, they're marching in. They're marching in. How is it that all of those policemen, all those SWAT members cannot find a registered nurse and a secretary in the front office for over 4 hours? You tell me that.
Wow. Yeah.
What kind of search is that? Are we that bad? And they said they searched the entire school 3 times, not once, not twice, 3 times. And that is coming out of the words of the public information officer, Lieutenant Paul Vance from the Connecticut State Police. We're going to search every crook and cranny. And then when they find a nurse, that is a registered nurse, they tell her to close her eyes so she doesn't see the blood. What the hell do you think registered nurses do? They deal with blood.
Wow.
It just doesn't add up.
Yeah, and that's what we typically see with these events that we believe are false flags. Just like we saw with the Boston bombing, The FBI said, we've got a tape of them doing, all we saw them was them walking down the street, walking around a corner. That was the only thing that they showed. And yet they said, we've got pictures of them placing the bombs in place, but they wouldn't show anybody. And the governor said, yeah, I've, you know, that's what happened. They have the tapes. And somebody asked him, have you seen it? It's like, no, I haven't seen it. He's just going with what they tell him. And that's what they want everybody to do.
And again, you know what that's called? Misdirection. It's like you go on the David Copperfield show. Yes. You watch him perform, and you walk out of there saying, dadgummit, how in the world did he do that, okay? And you actually believe he did that, but you know it's an illusion. That's exactly, I think, what they did at Sandy Hook. They convinced us, and right now we're going to put the pieces of the puzzle together because we know it was a trick. It was an illusion. We're going to put the puzzle together, and we're going to figure this thing out.
Well, you said that you're going to go to Newtown. What do you hope to accomplish at Newtown, since nobody will talk to you?
Well, I think it's important, because being an educator and working as a national school consultant, making our schools safer, I want to have a conversation with board members as to why they will not respond to my Connecticut Freedom of Information request, which are really simple. Who was the contractor? The name of the contractor, and how much money did it cost to install the security system at Sandy Hook? Mm-hmm. You know what? What the answer was? Well, we can't tell you that because it'll put all the children in Sandy Hook and teachers at risk. Tell me how that would put anybody at risk. The name of who put it in and how much did it cost? They will not tell you.
That would open them up for some lawsuits, because obviously it needs to be fixed, right? If what they say happened really happened, right?
Absolutely. And you know what? Here's the other question, you know, again. Who did the Newtown Public Schools and school board contract, environmental company did they contract to clean up all of the biohazard? You're talking about, if it's true, 45 to 60 gallons of blood splatter everywhere, bone fragments, brain tissues. I mean, the carpet would be soaked with blood. They would have to remove everything. And you got to remember, people don't know this because they don't know how to read a police report. The crime scene are in room 8, room 10, and outside of room 9. And that's what they have to focus on. Don't worry about the woods and people chasing each other.
Yes.
Stay focused on what happened in those three areas. That's a piece of the puzzle.
Well, that's why it's so vitally important. You know, this always comes out after the fact. Eventually it comes out. Usually it's someone who's putting together a documentary film who doesn't believe it. And they'll usually get someone who's an expert in detective work, somebody who's had law enforcement experience. You did this because that's your profession. That's what you do, is you look at how to make the schools more safe. It's very, very valuable what you're doing here. Tell us, we've got time for one more. What's one more thing that really sticks out at you?
The one that really sticks out is, if you listen to the police transmission, this is important. A lot of people don't know what the terminologies are and how law enforcement speak to each other. But if you listen to the dispatcher's communication at 9:55, 31 a.m. on December 14th, 2012, there's a police officer who's inside the school. He's calling dispatch, and he says, dispatch, we have multiple weapons. We have multiple weapons. We have rifles and a shotgun. Mm-hmm. So that means he's inside the classroom. He's actually seeing a rifle and a shotgun. Where's the shotgun? Where did it disappear to? And you know what room he's in? He's actually in room 10, where supposedly Adam Lanza committed suicide and dead bodies are everywhere. But he says, I have multiple weapons, rifle and a shotgun. Now, these are his words, not yours, not mine. Mm-hmm. Now, where's the weapons? Where's the shotgun? But what they do, they tell you, well, the shotgun's in the trunk. See, misdirection.
That's right, and we covered that at the very beginning. We had video footage of them pulling it out of the trunk, and if I remember correctly, I think that car doesn't even belong to the Lanza family. Isn't that correct?
You can change it any way you want.
Yeah.
But the point is, they've done a great job. I mean, I have to admit, they should win an Oscar. I think whoever directed it, whoever created the script, I think it's a 2.5-3 year project.
Yes.
I think they should get an Oscar, because they have fooled a lot of people.
Well, you know, those of us here at InfoWars believe that this isn't the first time they've done a false flag. They've been planning and executing these things for quite some time in many, many different areas. We've got Operation Northwoods and many other things that they planned. Some of them they executed, some of them they didn't execute. It's just the way they get their agenda put forward, and we've seen this over and over again throughout history. We've seen governments doing it, but our government is really a master at doing this sort of thing. But thank you so much for your investigation into this. We want to keep in contact with you. We want to know what's going on with this. And please be very, very careful if you do go to Connecticut.
Yep. And also remember, please, to your listener, help us piece the puzzle together. If all of this is a puzzle, don't get distracted with anything else. One piece at a time, and they just won't give you the answer. They will not respond or return phone calls. And I really thank you for giving us an opportunity today, okay, to have a conversation.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Halbig. Is there any way that people can help you other than information?
Well, we're we're setting up a Sandy Hook Justice Trust Fund. We need to hire attorneys. We need to file civil lawsuits. We need to get people in Connecticut to raise their right hand. There are certain people that need to be... they need to be deposed, and I think that's the only way we're ever going to find the truth. And I tell you what, there are a ton of people that are ready to go. But if they're interested, you know, they can look at Facebook up. If they want to donate, they can. It's a trust fund. Nobody's going to tamper with it. Nobody's going to steal money. It's to hire the attorneys and find the solutions.
And where do they find that on Facebook? We've got the website up, Children's Safety Institute.com.
It's just under Wolfgang W. Halbig. You know, if you just find it.
Okay.
Find me, Wolfgang Halbig.
All right, great, great. Well, we'll hope people will help you with that.
Thank you very, very much.
Thank you. Thank you for your efforts.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Well, I hope you'll consider supporting him. He's a man of integrity who is eminently qualified to do this kind of investigation with experience in both law enforcement and school safety. He's got questions. If they're really interested in keeping our kids safe rather than confiscating legal gun owners' guns, they would give up that information. But we see how it's met. It's met with intimidation and harassment, just as Obama does to his other political enemies, people who want to expose what he's doing. And you can support us here at Prison Planet TV by getting a subscription. You can share that with up to 10 other people simultaneously. It's a great way to spread the information, and it's a great way to support us here. Well, that's it for tonight. We'll be back tomorrow at 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern.
Now you can watch The Alex Jones Show live as it happens at InfoWars.com/show.
You'll find links to all of our content there and a free 15-day trial for Prison Planet TV.
More than 60 movies and documentaries all in one place at InfoWars.com/show.